guys. So I am 12 weeks post-op, and as I mentioned on my last video, I've started core strengthening this past few days. So if you're like me, you definitely have really significant abdominal weakness. Like, I can tell even when I'm laying down, I used to pop up, you know, out of bed, and now I've gotten pretty fast at it now, and I don't really think twice about when I'm doing the movement, but I do notice that I don't just come up straight, that I kind of roll over to the side and then come up. So I definitely want to get those muscles back strong, because I have the vertical cut, and so it goes above my belly button, so I have a pretty wide amount of area that was cut through. So, I mean, it's still healing. It's going, you know, the healing takes place over several months, but I'm at the point now where I'm comfortable with going ahead and kind of doing some of those foundational core strengthening exercises. So I'm going to go over those, and if you're comfortable doing those, make sure you're cleared by your doctor. So feel free to try them on your own time. In a perfect world, I would do them 2 to 3 times a day, but I've been only doing it one to two times a day. But I've also been doing a lot of other exercises too, but I'm trying my best to try to incorporate things that really focus just on my core. Okay, this first one is really simple, but it is really, really important. So we're going to talk about diaphragmatic breathing. So I want you to take a moment and take 3 breaths for me. I want you to look at if your chest rises or if your belly rises. So take 3 breaths for me. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if your belly went up and down, you're good to go. But if your chest went up and down, okay, you got some work to do, but it's okay. So your lungs, it go, you know, below your ribs. So your chest is up high. So you want that air to go deep into your lungs and get, you know, the oxygen that it needs. So this one is very simple. I'm going to change my camera angle and show you how to do it. Okay. Notice how my chest is moving up and down? No good. Okay, so you want to make sure your breath goes deep. And this is when you're exercising, when you're walking, when you're working. You want to always make sure you're breathing deep into your belly and make sure that your belly is rising and falling. So this is the correct way to breathe during these exercises that we're going to do. So just like that. So with all these exercises that we do, when I say breathe with it, that's what I mean. I want you to breathe through your belly, where you're breathing through your lungs, but I want you to breathe deep into your belly and have it rise and fall and not have the air getting trapped into your chest and not, you know, getting everything you need. Okay, next we're going to do what is called a pelvic rotation. Some of us naturally have a pelvis that's rotated forward. So in this exercise, we're going to be rotating our pelvis backwards. And it's going to cause us to activate those kind of inner core muscles. All right, we're going to show you how to do that one. All right, so we're going to lay down. And most of us, you're going to notice there's going to be a little space up under your back. So what we're going to do is you want to squish that area. So you're going to rotate that pelvis back, and it's going to close up that space right there. So while you're holding it, make sure you're doing those nice good breaths. So the way you know that you're really doing it, so your belly button's right here, you can take your hand and kind of push deep into your stomach and then do your pelvic tilt. So, and you'll fill up that muscle
contract and pop up into your fingers. So when that becomes a little bit more easier to do, you can progress it by doing that pelvic tilt and then raising your leg, straighten it, but you gotta keep that back flat. Try not to lose it, and then bring it back in and back down. And then do the other one, keeping that back flat, raise that leg, straighten it out, and bring it back. Shoot for, you know, 10 seconds at first, and then work your way up to about 30 or 45 seconds. So this exercise is called the dead bug. So you want to do that pelvic tilt that we learned in the last part. Hold that pelvic tilt. Bring your legs up into a 90 degree angle, and then lift your arms straight up. So while maintaining that pelvic tilt, you want to straighten one arm and the opposite leg. Bring it back. And then straighten the other side. And you want to hold that for about 3 seconds at first. So I don't know if you noticed two compensations that you're going to look for. So you're going to compensate if you have a weak core by bringing your knees forward and by dropping your feet down. So it's hard at first, but you want to make sure you maintain that correct form. In the first few days, I had a lot of issues with that just because I have a really significant weakness going on. So just make sure you're aware of that. Try to keep your legs in this position. So I'm going to rest for a second because keeping my pelvis rotated is tiring after a minute. But it does get easier. I can definitely feel a difference today versus the first day I started. So going to that pelvic tilt, get into position. Okay, and extend. Take a breath when I get back to the originating position. So it's a deep breath. And then once I exhale out, then I alternate. And bring it back. Deep breath. I'm gonna do it one more time just to make sure you got it. So, okay, go to your pelvic tilt, into position, deep breath, and exhale while you're extending out. Remember, it's opposite hand and opposite foot, and out. One more. Deep breath and out. Good. So make sure when you extend out that you're trying not to touch your heels to the floor. If it's really tough at first, then you can kind of rest it down, then bring it back up, but then try to progress to not having your heel touch the ground once you straighten it out. Make sure you work on that for a week or two before you progress to anything else. That one's really gonna target your core muscles. All right, this is the last one. pretty easy also, but if you have a pretty weak core, it's going to be challenging. So we're going to get on hands and knees. Make sure your knees are right under your hip and your hand is right under your shoulder. So it's kind of easy that you want to automatically, you know, do this exercise and have the dip in your back. But again, you want to rotate that pelvis so that it's kind of in a more, your back is more straight and doesn't have that dip in it. So get it into a pretty normal position. And then again, you want to do alternating hands and knees. So you're going to be kicking that leg out. You're going to be reaching forward with your hand. So get into your normal position. And then look forward and extend out. Try to hold it for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And back down. Take a good breath and then extend out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when I first started this, I was only doing about 3 seconds. So just do what you can and then work your way up until you can kind of hold it for, you know, anywhere from 15 to 30 seconds. So make sure your back is straight. And a lot of times when you start, you might have your hands out and it'd be kind of in an angle. But you don't want to do that because that means you're using other muscles to kind of compensate. So bring those hands right up under your shoulder. Take a good breath. And extend out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. I guarantee you the first day I was wobbling all over the place just to get to 5 seconds. So don't worry if it's a little bit more challenging. So those are the 4 exercises I've been doing. I've started to try to do a little plank, but I can do it for about 10 seconds now. The first day I started these exercises, I was only doing it for about 3 seconds. So maybe remember, baby steps. You're going to get there. All right, so this concludes my video. If you have any issues or concerns about any of those 4 things, just drop me a comment and I'll try to get back with you. And then, you know, good luck with progressing past that. If you really have any issues, make sure you talk to your doctor and they can refer you to a physical therapist who can work one-on-one with you to try to get your core where it needs to be. All right. See you later.